everybody. I just called the post office and my chicks came and I'm so excited, so I'm gonna go get them right now. But first, I just gotta put food and water inside of the brooder, so we're gonna go do that right now. Right. Okay, so this right here, this is the garage and this is their little brooder that I made for them. So it's just a cardboard box and I put some shavings and stuff in there. And that's their water, that's their food, there's their heat lamp. So I'm just gonna put water in there and some food and we're gonna go to the post office. All right, here's their feed bag. Got all that good chicken feed. I'm gonna fill this up. Okay, here's the feeder. Oh, I gotta get a cup. Hold on, let me get a cup. Just gonna fill this up with some chick feed. They're probably hungry. I got their waterer right here. I gotta fill that with water. How many quarts is this? 5 quarts. And then I got these electrolytes for them so that, because you know, they've been in the mail for like 2 days, so they need something to help them right away because they haven't drank water or eaten in 2 days. All right, so I have to mix one of these with 1 gallon of water. I'll be right back. All right, here's the water. I never used one of these before, so like I hope all the water doesn't spill out, but I don't think it will. So you just put that on there. You twist it. Yeah, okay. All right, let's see. Cool, it works. Now, I need to get this plugged in, so I'm gonna get an extension cord, which I have one right here. Get an extension cord and we'll plug this in. Oh my god, I'm so excited. I just can't like calm down right now. Turn that on. Is that on? Yeah, that's on. Okay. All right. Now we're just gonna turn on the brooder. We'll plug this in. All right, the brooder's on and it's ready to go. Now we gotta go to the post office and pick up the chicks. All right, gotta go to the post office. Right, post office, where are you? I've never been to the post office over here, so this will be my first time. There we go.
The destination is on your left. U.S. Post Office.
Post Office.
Arrived.
All right. Okay, so I just got my chicks from the post office. I didn't open them yet. They're in here. But I'm just hoping that there's no casualties. I'm hoping. So let's see. Oh, hi, babes! They look all alive to me. I think they're all alive. Yeah, they're all alive. Oh my god, they're so cute! All right, let's get you home. All right, time to put them in their new home. Okay, so I have to take each one and then I'm gonna dip their beaks in the water so they know where it's at, and then they'll just do their thing. All right, grab you first. Oh my God, they're so small. You're so small. Okay, and then we'll just dip its beak in the water. And it's in its new home. Okay, next one. Hi, babe. The babes are here. They're eating, they're drinking, they're adapting quickly. All right, the chicks are in their little spot, and Ginger has never seen chickens before, baby chicks. But Mom has, so she's like familiar with all this. So I want to see how he reacts when he sees the little chicks. Ginger! Ginger! Look at him. As soon as I call my name, he comes running. All right, as soon as I call his name, he comes running. Come on, Ginge! I got a surprise. I got a surprise. Come on. Are you ready to meet some new friends? Some new friends? Huh? Oh yeah, boy. Let's go. Let's see what he does. Come on, Ginge. Come on. He hears it. He's like, what the heck? He probably thinks it's a bird outside. Come on. Come on. You want to see the chicks? Look it. Look. Oh, Ginger. Look it. He's like, what the hell? Ginger. Here, we'll put him on top of here so we can see him better. Look at the chicks. He's not interested. That's good because I was afraid that he might attack them or something.
Chicks? You want to say hi? Okay. Yeah, they're friends. They're our friends. Gotta love them.
Okay. What do you see? Okay, since I have the camera out, I'm gonna show you guys how my seedlings are doing and what I've been doing. I had COVID for like the past 2 weeks, but I don't have COVID anymore. So that's why I haven't been posting any videos. But there's like, I've been doing a lot of stuff, and I actually transplanted my lettuce, my spinach, my radicchio, and what else? And arugula. So those are over here. I transplanted these, I believe, like 4 days ago, and they're all alive, they're all doing good. So we just gotta wait and see when they get a little bigger, and then we can eat them. So over here, this one is little gem lettuce, this one is radicchio, this one is spinach, and then this one I have, I believe this is little gem lettuce, and then there's also spinach, and then I have arugula, and then this one is just a mix of like whatever I had left. So there are those. They're looking good. And in this bed I also have a bunch of parsley. There's parsley, there's fennel here, and then I also have oregano. And I have some oregano growing in the garden, and I'm gonna put that in this bed soon, but not just yet because they're really small still. And we have some fennel over here too. And then in the greenhouse, it's probably hot in here. I have to keep this door open today because it's gonna be like, I think like almost 80 degrees today. So we'll keep this open. And so the tomatoes were growing, like they were getting so big, so they couldn't stay in these little cells any longer. So I didn't do all of them yet, but I transplanted most of them into little separate containers. So I did the Amish paste and I did the beefsteak. So those have their own separate containers here. These ones are Amish paste, and then I have a lot more Amish paste down here. And then I also have San Marzano tomatoes up here, which those desperately need transplanting because there's like just so many. See all the roots? There's a lot of plants in here. So these need to go to different containers, their own containers, so that they can grow to their full potential. And I need to sow some more of these little peperoncino, the little round ones, because I only have one plant and that's not enough. I need at least 7 or 8 plants. So I'm gonna plant some more of those seeds, but everything else is looking really good. The eggplants, jalapenos, different types of peppers back here, everything's looking really good. And then these bell pepper seeds, they were just a year old, but I only got one plant out of them, but I'm not really worried because I have so many pepper plants. And here's the kale. I gotta get these planted ASAP. And flowers, we got more flowers down here. Those are growing really good. Cabbage, I'm waiting for to prep the garden, to put those in the garden. And there's like a couple more spinach and stuff, but I'm not really worried about those. Onions are looking really good, and that's about it. And Ginger's just chilling. Let's go for a walk. There's a hummingbird nest up here. Right there. You wanna come with me? Come on. Got some beautiful flowers over here. I don't know what kind of flowers these are, but I've always seen them ever since I was a little kid, but I have no idea what they're called. Here's the garden. So this year, we only have a section of it rototilled, but we're gonna, this year we're gonna rototill the entire thing. So there's gonna be like no grass in here. So this will all be dirt, this will all be dirt, and then obviously all of this also. And I just got some weeds growing in here. And I have some salad growing in a bunch of places too. But I didn't, last year, I spread seeds over here. Or not last year, in 2019 we spread seeds once the season was over, and then they started growing again in 2020. So we had lettuce, but this year, or last year in 2020, I didn't do that. Mainly because I didn't think about it, I forgot. But I have some lettuce growing where the chicken coop was. And yeah, but I also have some, I don't know what this is called, but it's a type of lettuce. And it's really sour, but it tastes really good. So we got those, but these grow here every year. My grandpa, he just always spread seeds everywhere and they just grow back every year. So that's, it's like it's no-no salad. And I'm gonna show y'all the lettuce that's in the coop, which is right over here. There's so many weeds in there. I need the chickens to get bigger so that they can eat everything. But I don't think I'm gonna be using this coop in the summertime, because I'm gonna get one of those Premier One fences so that they can just graze on the fresh grass every day. So there's some garlic in here. I have a couple garlic plants. And lettuce. See all of this right here? That is all lettuce. And there's also some onions that were left from last year. I don't know how I missed them, but that's okay. There's like three of them. But yeah, that's about it. That's all that's been going on. There's nothing really special that's been going on, because I'm just waiting for everything to grow. But now I just got to get a move on with this chicken coop and really start working on it for when the chickens get a little bigger. But they're not going to be able to live in there until they're at least like 6 weeks old. So they're only 2 days old, so I got time. But yeah. So I don't know exactly like which breeds of chicks I got, except two of them. I got two different kinds of Polish chickens, the one that has like the little top hat. But the other ones I just got, like the McMurray hatching assortment or egg assortment or whatever, so that I would get like a bunch of different colors of eggs. But there's like, I would say there's at least, they added maybe four different varieties, maybe five, plus I have the two Polish ones. So yeah, I'm not really like completely sure, but I know, I'm pretty sure that I have a couple Rhode Island Reds in there, but the other ones I'm not really sure. But I'm gonna show you guys the cute little ones. Oh my god, I'm so excited. Here's one of them. Isn't she cute? She's so quiet and so nice. Okay, put her back. There you go. Here's another one. This one is a little black one. Black and yellow. Oh, he's pooping. Okay, I'm gonna put her back. This one's a chirper. Ooh! Here's that one. So cute. I'll put her back. There's a couple other ones, and then I'm gonna show you the two Polish. So I have a golden Polish, and then I have a black one. So here's the here's the golden one. So you can see she has a little top hat. She's super cute. But the black one is even cuter. Hi, say hi. You're so pretty. Okay, I'm gonna put her back. There you go. Go back. Go back. And last but not least, well, this one's my favorite one. The golden, or the black lace Polish, or gold. I don't know exactly what they're called. All I know is that they're Polish chickens, so. But he's eating right now. I don't know what I wanna name, I definitely wanna name the two Polish ones that I have, because I can like tell those one, I can tell those ones out from the different ones. All right, he's done eating. Come here, boy. Okay, this one's my favorite one. What a cutie. Hi. I just love their little top hats. Like, how cute is that? Aww. Ooh. You can't go up there. You can't go up there, buddy. These chickens are, they are 2 days old. So they were hatched on Monday, and then I got them shipped today. Today's Wednesday. So they're 2 days old. So I hope that they all survive, because this is my first time raising chickens by myself. So, I mean, I think they'll all survive. The brooder is the right temperature and they have food and water. So I don't know why they wouldn't survive. But yeah, so I'm just gonna keep watching them, because they're super cute, and I can't wait till they get bigger.